Yo, what's up, everybody? How you doing? Right. Nice to be back with y'all. Right on. I just made another video just before this one, and it was all on negativity. And if you haven't watched that yet, you know, you should go do that. But if you have watched it, you know, I wouldn't go watch it again or anything. If, you know, if you have watched it already and you need to go watch some, you know, I would say go watch Psy's Gangnam Style, you know what I'm saying? Even if you've seen it more than once, go watch it twice or like a million times, you know what I'm saying? So that it will go up to like a trillion views, and then Psy can become like the Korean Messiah of pop stars, and he can lead the whole world to peace. You know what I'm saying? Because I think that guy knows what's up, but maybe he don't, and I'm just tripping. But that's crazy talk anyway, because today we ain't gonna go no there with like that's wrong stupidity things. We just gonna leave it in the dust, and we're gonna kick that off our sandal and move to the next thing, which is positive materialism. That's what today's video is on. Be positive. Yeah. This is all about the positivity, love and light now. Alright, so positive materialism, that's all about abundance and all. Wait a minute, that's still all that spiritualist crap. Alright man, now positive materialism is actually something else. Alright, so we won't get down to the bottom of this, but first of all, let's talk about some evidence, okay? First of all, be positive, all right? That you guys came to my channel and you left some negativity up in here and you said, hey, yo, we don't like the way you filmed this video on a calculator and you sound like you got your sound levels all fucked up and you basically too stupid to fix it, so why should anybody listen to you talk about how science don't exist because you use a computer to make it, all right? So you stupid. All right, so I got that. I'm stupid, but that's cool. This is the thing. Be positive. I said I want to be positive, that you understand that I heard your criticism. So like 100 videos in, it wasn't that I didn't want to like help you out and change the mic level, but it was like this, you know what I'm saying? I just didn't give a fuck, you know what I'm saying? All right, so that's my thing, that's my bad, you know what I'm saying? So now I done changed the mic level, right. And so I changed the mic level and, you know, I changed 66%, which for those of you who ain't all into like the spiritual craziness, you will say that's 2/3, you know, and it's 66.6%. And it's 66.666666666 up into infinity, because 66.6 don't ever go nowhere. It's like one of the most important destinations in the whole percentage theorem of like tiered mathematics or whatever you want to talk about, sets, like you know, etc. Yeah, you all the mathematicians know what I'm talking about. If you're a spiritual person, you probably don't know what I'm talking about, because you probably don't know nothing about math then, right? That's a positive materialist worldview. I'm pretty sure about it, all right? Pretty sure. All right, so that's why this video is like this, all right? So if you can hear me and I don't sound all crackly and like terrible and shit, then you hear, I don't have no accents or anything this time. I talk exactly as I did when I was a kid, or was, well, maybe not. But anyways, this is more like the way I would sound if you were kicking it with me at the bar and we were playing pool and drinking beer. Be positive about that. All right, so this improved sound quality, is that the truth? We will find out later. I'm going to have to get your opinion on that, and so I can be positive, right? So I'm going to need to get some data on that so that I can, like, figure it out, alright? But here's the thing, it's proof positive. You give me that data, then I know, alright, then the sound level better. And if I can figure out where is the best sound level, then I'll become a good producer and maybe one day I can be a DJ. Alright, so proof positive, alright. How do you arrive at proof? That's the proof. What is proof positive and how do you arrive at proof? Alright, well wait. Is proof positive? That's what I'm really trying to get at. See, here's another thing. I changed my script this time. This one, I want to be positive, right? So since I wanted to be positive, I gave myself a script. Usually I work off of independent, you know, I just in the moment and I just try to be here now and I improvise the whole thing, you know what I'm saying? But I don't really do that because I think about it a little bit beforehand. So I kind of like give myself like a little mental script rehearsal, like give myself a title and then just talk about that. But then I just talk, You know what I'm saying? But so this time I have a script. So this time I have a script because I want to be positive. So I think about myself, man. So if I make the sound better and I have a script, I get a better video, right? All right. So if I did, you let me know. Proof positive, it works. All right. So all right, is proof positive? Is proof positive? Is proof positive? Proof a good thing? Well, we're gonna find out. All right. So how do we arrive at proof? First of all, that's a good question that we need to ask. And the reality is that if it's a good thing or a bad thing, the way that you arrive at proof of something is usually prove that the opposite is not there. Negativity. You use negative. You use a negative. You null hypothesis. You know, you're going to prove all other options untrue so that there's only one thing left, and then that's the proof. Right? It's all about like deductive versus inductive thinking. One of them is bad and one of them is good, but I can't ever remember which one. All right. So through the negative, you're going to get the positive. And so if you have this positive view, like, if you have this negative view, like, you positive about everything already, right? That's the negative view, right? These are people who know without knowing. So, like, faith, for example, is if you're a positive materialist, faith is, like, claiming that you know something when you don't really know it, right? Well, that's not exactly what it is if you're a positive materialist in the sense that you pay attention to, like, all the different expressions of faith in, you know, speaking anthropologically about religion and how what's all been written about the subject and how people actually already feel about it and what it serve, like, what a function does it serve, like a physiological function maybe. This sort of thing has to be explained and, you know, analyzed if you want to be a positive materialist and you talk about faith. But most positive materialists, by that I'm talking about people who are, you know, all positive materialists, you should be atheists because there ain't no positive material proof for God. And you should be, like, all up on science nuts because they make computers and shit that are better than, like, calculators in the beginning. It's like, who needs a calculator when you can do math on paper? Nobody can, so you need a calculator. And a computer, you don't even need a calculator. You got a computer now. And now you don't even need a computer. You got a cell phone. Like, a cell phone that does everything. It's, like, better than a Batman belt. You know what I'm saying? But anyways, all right. So this is positive materialism. Get more. Got to have better stuff. Technology's got to get to be the ultimate thing. Guns and weapons and shit, they all get better. People are positive. They're materialists. They want stuff. And they know the right. You know what I'm saying? So then they have the right, and they're like, hey, we got the right. We are our way is better than your way. We are positive about that shit, and we want your shit, so we don't come steal your materials. All right. We're going to do it with our materials. You know what I'm saying? And that's like kind of like the landscape of the human drama over like however many years. All right. So that's what I'm saying is like there's good. That's just, is proof positive? Is positivity, actually positive? Whoa. See, the thing is most people don't want to count from 1 to 0 to negative 1. And doing math is, like, hard because you leave the fucking plus or the minus off, and then you're wrong. You know what I'm saying? You come out with plus 1 when you're supposed to come out with negative 1. And then, you know, you don't know. But, see, that's why I say 1-0, and that's what a computer works on, and that's why it's easier. That's proof positive that maybe there's something to Tai Chi that science picked up on, and that's what they developed computers out of. So for all of those of you who thought that what I was saying about religion is development of science, you could say, well, that's wrong, but reality is that's how it happened. There's positive proof of the evolution of scientific theories and where they came from and how university structures and systems like all got developed and who was what. And so you could go study that for yourself because I ain't going to talk about it today. What's positive? Positive. All right. So we talk about all these things, positive, everybody. Talking about positivity, they think they know what it means. Well, positivity means a lot of different things. So it means you got to become a quickabilist. You got to become ready to flex your, you know, sexy tongue on the cunning linguist. You know what I'm saying? That's a reference for all my lesbian friends out there. Vote lesbian next election cycle. But anyways, that's what I'm saying, right? If you're going to be positive about something, if you want to be positive about a speech, you need notes and a pen. You know what I'm saying? That's why everybody on TV got notes and a pen, because they are going to be positive that they can write down what they said. That's why, you know, scientists were working on building a body of logic, right? You got to actually have an epistemology, and you actually have to have a phylogeny. You actually have to have these things to make it so that you can say to yourself, look, we built this large collective body of linguistics, of culture, of evidence, of proof, of belief. We've got this whole thing worked out, and now we're the authorities of this, and we can level society with it. You know what I'm saying? Because the random chaos of freedom is more than, you know, anyone in power is equipped to handle. So that's positive, right? So positive is like when you know what I'm saying. And it's not no, it's a no, you know what I'm saying. You're positive. I'm absolutely positive. And you say, well, no, positive is when you just smile and you just be happy and just make yourself feel good and just do whatever you want. Whatever anybody said that you don't like, just dismiss it and be like, that's negative, I don't like that. And you just make everything in your life just better by just being positive, by being happy all the time. Just don't let any negativity in whatsoever. And then, so that's positive too. Oh, wait, that's the Kabbalistic view. See, complex, it means different things to different people at different times in different ways. But both of them come together to form a holistic, unified field of theory. Oh, okay, so that's the anthropological note on Kabbalism real quick. But, all right, so then what is materialism? All right, materialism, what is materialism? Check it out. I got these things, man. I got, look at this. Love and light now. That was my love and light nail right there. You see that? I got props. Fucking, I can acapella too. How does singing sound on that 66.6% microphone? All right, I got a pen, right? I got a script, right? I got a fucking calculator that's actually a laptop, and then I got my sunglasses on my eyes because I like the bling. You know what I'm saying? I already wore my little Buddha beads too for that. You know, that's what I'm saying. I'm trying to acquire as much material effects as possible. I got a real, you know, gnarly lighting scheme and everything. And, like, trying to be comfortable and just talking my normal way. And so this is what I'm saying, man. I'm, like, positive about my materialism right here because I got good material, right? This material is off the chain, baby. It's, like, bling, bling. But anyways, I got my stuff. And I got my positivity, and so then that way you're going to tie these two things together. Because when you see in the spiritual world, people be talking about positivity and materialism, that's what they be doing. They be like, I'm alive now! And then they be like, abundance, abundance, abundance. And so then you can say, like, in the other world, you got the motherfuckers who are like, well, we invented light. We invented the lighter. We invented the process it needs to take this lighter and fill it up with gas and then go bam. You know what I'm saying? They own all the stuff. They made all the stuff. They are the only ones who know how to engineer stuff. And if I didn't have them, you know what I'm saying, I'd be back to making hand axes on, like, shafts of, like, wood and, like, hunting, like, raccoons in the streets of Sebastopol, which would be terrible. But anyways, you see what I'm saying? So you got these people who have, they've done the math, they've proven the proof, they have eliminated all the anti-possibilities, and they have soaked up everybody else's freedom. And so they've already come to the point where they say, hey, look, we got this all figured out. We don't need your help no more. Thank you very much. You can apply at the fucking grocery store down the road. And then you go down to the grocery store down the road, and while you're sweeping floors and cleaning bathrooms, people are like, hey, dude, why are you down here, man? Why are you ain't up at the university teaching people stuff? And you be like, oh, man, because you get arrested when you go out in the middle of the quad in university and you start preaching to people, you know what I'm saying? So that's the way it is, man. But anyway, so let's talk about this in the negative spiritual worldview. We already did that, you know what I'm saying? But, like, let's, like, flesh it out and, like, draw up a, like, a matrix so we can be positive about the material components of this argument. And that's what I'm going to do right now, is that this positive materialist view, it has some fallbacks that namely come in the form of well, let's say less than virtuous behavior that is of a certain nature that just like, I don't know, if you display it towards others, you might get ahead in society and all that, but like, people are probably not apt to be very genuine with you, and you're probably gonna have to do, you know, things that your grandma would disapprove of if you want to get ahead. But anyway, so that's what I'm saying, that this positive materialist worldview, that it kind of comes, goes hand in hand with greed and fantasies and selfishness, and it kind of lacks empathy for others. And so it's hard for me to understand how the love and light nail and the keep it all positive, let's all have abundance crowd can like say, hey, we got the spiritual shit because we got too much of everything, and we don't understand half of it. So anyways, more or less to the point, then we got the positivist, materialist reality of the world today. Let's talk about this shit right here real quick, because it affects your social relationships. The positivist, materialist worldview in the history of like the last several, say the last two centuries of how it has been handled in the institutions of religion, of education, not the institutions of religion, but the secular religions of education. The universities have gone down, right? Here's how social systems have gone down in universities for however long, is that there's this guy, he's positivist materialist, and he lays out a set of critiques of society that are the backbone of all now liberal education, whether you want to admit it or not. The guy's name is Karl Marx, right? So in the 1840s, this guy released this book called Communist Manifesto. And that's not the backbone of his theories, because his theories are actually based on economics. And the Communist Manifesto was like more like a flashy, you know, song and dance that he did. It was like his own little Bhagavad Gita. And and in it, he expresses some things that have to do with something called communism, which is a whole nother barrel of fish. But he is also responsible for fueling a philosophical breach of paradigm that built a new paradigm that was all about positive materialism. All right, so like, first of all, he's basically saying that it all comes down to stuff, and that you can be positive about certain things if you follow the stuff, right? You follow the money, follow the economics. That way you can make properly informed decisions and have a discourse that's meaningful when it comes to society. All right, so that's Marxism, which is different than communism. The Communist Manifesto has some Marxist principles in it, and there's all kinds of Marxist people who, you know, in the past, what they've done is that they have taken that thing and they have said, you know, whatever they want to say, and they've applied it to their own historical narratives at the time and their place in history and everything in their geographic and chronological orientation within the world, right? But here's the thing, communism doesn't belong to Karl Marx, all right? And it doesn't belong to Lenin or Stalin or Mao or Pol Pot or Castro or Chavez or anybody else, okay? It doesn't belong to anyone else. It doesn't even belong to Warren Beatty, who made that movie Reds, all right? So look at this, all right? It doesn't even belong to the guy that he played, okay? So this is what I'm saying. Communism is actually something much older. And if you know anything about Mormonism in the United States of America, you know that Joseph Smith came up with communism before Karl Marx did. So that's one thing that you don't know, all right? But that's something that I know, so you could be positive about that. All right, so back to the evidence at hand. There was other positivist materialist proof of communism before it came, because what the Communist Manifesto expresses, that doesn't have nothing to do with necessarily how it was politically handled in any country at the time, is that if you are living in a time where the basic boundaries of what is acceptable to you as a human being who has to be part of the system that you're part of, that you can look at that system and have a dignity, integrity, and you can have a positive view of where you stand. You're going to like it. You know what I'm saying? You're going to be like, hey, yeah, I got enough stuff, and I got the right rights, and I'm happy with the system as it is, right? So if you like that, then you're not going to see the value of this communistic idea. But if you are not like that and you say, hey, I'm trampled upon, I get squat, I'm fucking eating rocks and mud and weeds for soup at the end of the day because I don't got fucking not fuck else to do nothing with, okay? Well, then you don't really feel like the system serves you. And so what it says is if the system doesn't serve you, bind yourself together with other people. Draw a little circle around your asses and start to sing. You know what I'm saying? Make your little hip-hop nation. Make your Raider nation. Make your fucking Jewish nation. Make your fucking, you know, baptism down by the river. Get your motherfucking shake on. Do your thing with your people. And then they can't come at you no more. You know what I'm saying? So if you're alienated by society, you have to join together with your peers. And you have to make your own revolution happen that fucking fixes whatever the conflicts are that you are facing. So that's one of the, that's not what it says, all right? That's not what the book says. That's my interpretation of it going forward in this modern worldview. And I'm saying, this doesn't have nothing to do with materialism. You should know that already. But anyways, this is where it gets into the terms of, like, way too much, you know what I'm saying? Way too much information. For example, in this country, if you even talk about communism or Marxism, you're already dead in the water, right? Everybody's going to crucify you from that moment forward because in this country, it's illegal to talk about Marxism and communism, even if they kind of create the idea that it's not illegal to talk about it. It is. If you talk about it, you automatically, instantly going to draw the attention of the authorities and they are going to fucking do what they can, if they may, to roast you out and put you to rest. You know what I'm saying? That's been proven. That's the history of the nation, in every nation, since the beginning of the nation, since the abomination of the Stella of Hammurabi. That's the nation's principles. If you don't agree with the nation, proof positive material, they're going to kick your ass and move you out, right? A negative spiritual worldview, on the other hand, doesn't bother with what other people are doing because it doesn't need to worry about what other people's style is or how they're trying to get down, right? In a negative materialist worldview, the body and the self and the soul and the meditations of the mind are enough. And if you master those, you don't even really need to eat. That's the rumor, but nobody believes it. Anyways, this is what I'm saying. That's a positivist, materialist worldview. We got one that focuses on the individual, which is the positivist, materialist worldview. This is the not, you're not in a group, you're on your own. This is the big lie. And that's why I'm trying to say that this is positivist, materialist. Reality is, if you want to come up with an expression of revolution or resistance or adaptation or evolution that matters more than the tired ass shit that everybody else has already tried, you gotta try what everybody else has already tried from the perspective of yourself in the world where you're at around you. See, that's why I teach Tai Chi, teach people to think two things at once, because that's obviously a better way of doing things. You can be creative and still get your shit in order and line it all up and tie it all together. You see my point? I think you do. And this has been too long. That's proof positive that the dude should fucking be faster the next time he has notes and a pen and, you know, stupid glasses hanging from his chin. All right? Yeah, for real. Stop using a fucking calculator and adjust your mic levels.